Hi, John here. In this video, I'm going to talk about microclimating and what it is and how it may affect a heat pump. I've had a lot of comments which I wanted to respond to in terms of saying the heat pump's too close to the fence or the heat pump's too close to the wall. It's not going to be efficient. And so I just wanted to pick up on those and cover those and do some tests and show you my findings and results with data and facts. We've got a 7 kilowatt air source heat pump installed in July 2023. It's down the side of the house. And the point I was talking about in terms of microclimating is shown here in this little picture. We've got a house, next to it is the heat pump, and then the other side of it is a fence, a boundary fence. And what can happen with a heat pump is that the ambient air is sucked in at the back of the heat pump. The heat is taken out of that air and the cooler air is then forced out through the fan out the front of the unit. If there's an obstruction in the front of it, it can cause a recycling issue. So the heat pump then just starts to recycle the cool air that's been expelled back into the intake, and that impacts the efficiency. And that's termed as microclimating. To see if our heat pump was suffering from that, I used a couple of things. The first thing was an anemometer, handheld anemometer, which I use for drone flying, and also some little smoke pellets or smoke generators. Before we get into the tests that I ran and show you the results of those tests, let's just have a look at what Vaillant recommends in terms of location for a heat pump installation. And there's a couple of things to be aware of. This is the manual that comes with the heat pump. It talks about the R290 refrigerant, which is a little bit more explosive-y than other refrigerants, and it's also heavier than air. So if it does leak, it then sinks downwards around the ground level. It talks about all the clearances that you need if you have doors and windows, air bricks, all that kind of thing. In our situation, it's not relevant because we don't have any doors, windows or anything like that in and around the area. So we can discount that. With a floor installation, it talks about choosing an installation site that isn't in a corner of a room or between walls or between fences. The reason for that is the line underneath. Prevent the return intake of air from the air outlet, microclimating. However, it's also worth pointing out, it says select an installation site at which the air inlet is not affected by strong winds. Position the unit at crosswise to the main direction of wind where possible. If the installation site is not protected against the wind, you should plan to set up a protective wall. With most installations, there's always a compromise about what you can and can't do in terms of what you've got to deal with, what the location is. And we spent a lot of time when we were doing the recce and the site visit in terms of where we could install the heat pump. The location that we've chosen is the best preference of all of the options available. We can't turn it round and have it facing down the alley, as some people have suggested, because of the point there. It'll actually be worse than where it is at the moment in terms of its performance, because that sort of channel between the two houses is like a wind tunnel. Conditions are very site specific, so it's very difficult for people who don't know the location to be able to comment and say, well, it's never going to work there, or you won't get enough wind there. That's one of the reasons why we mounted it and located it where we have. The only other option was to locate it in front of the kitchen window, which would then it incurred the R290 issue because those windows are opening, so we couldn't have located it there anyway. So let's have a look at the minimum clearances that Vaillant stipulate. They say to guarantee sufficient airflow and to facilitate maintenance, observe the minimum clearances that are specified. And there's three that we need to consider. So distance behind the back, which is 200 mil between a wall or wherever it is on the back of the unit. At the front of the unit, a minimum of 600 millimeters, 24 inches. And off to the side on A is 100 millimeters. And it's a closer view of the same data set. So our heat pump situated down the side of the house between the two houses. That's the view looking back into the garden. Here's a plan. This was the plan that was actually used for planning permission. And a couple of things to point out is the fence at the right at the top of the picture there. I've changed that style of fence to a slatted open style fence, which gives a good flow of air through it from what was previously a solid impenetrable fence in terms of wind. And also the direction of the wind. So north is up, south is facing down. And here are our clearances. So at the back of the unit, between the unit and the wall, we have 260 millimetres, 26 centimetres, just over 10 inches. At the front of the unit, we have 740 millimetres, 74 centimetres, almost 29 inches. And to the side, 60 centimetres. And there's a summary of the minimums and what the actuals are. Thumbs up on those. So my testing, I did three tests on different days. As you can see here, the first test was with a wind speed of 1.7, less than 1, so it was moving around a bit. Got the old smoke chappies out, lit them. They run for about 35 seconds, 40 seconds. So on a long stick, because the actual smoke thing gets very hot. I'm glad I didn't hold it. It says do not hold. And you can see here the smoke coming out the front. The wind direction is from the south, so it's blowing down the alley towards the fence area. And there's very little smoke coming back in. The majority of it, 99% of it, is going out down the side there. There's a bit of swirling around by the brick where it juts out for the extension. This is another test on the 7th of January, which is 1 degree outside. Wind direction in the same place. So as you can see here, smoke coming out and then being pushed down. And again, these are very light winds, 1 or 2 miles per hour. But you see there's quite a lot of wind being picked up here because it's channeled down this area. So it doesn't actually need that much wind for it to pick up here. You can see that on the anemometer. And this is the final test I did. This is the wind coming the other way, so it's coming towards the camera. So you can see it's getting blown out and pushed against the fence, but generally it's then just pulled away by the stream of wind. The perhaps is a little bit of recirculating there. In terms of into the back of the unit, but I don't think it's very much, and certainly nothing to worry about, as you'll see in a minute when we look at the figures and the performance of the unit. Also, at the end of the video, I managed to capture a defrost cycle, so I'll tack that on the end of the video, so hang about for that. You can see there's a bit of smoke channeling around the back, but the majority of it, the vast majority of it, is just being blown away. And again, it's blowing into the camera, so it's a bit deceiving in terms of its direction. So this is the My Vaillant app showing our current specs. This is for the 6th of January. This is the open energy monitoring data set for the same day. So 4.27 for the whole day. This was the 7th of January. So a 4.1 coefficient of performance there. And that's with no hot water. So it's a bit cooler outside. And this is where we are in the monitoring tables in the upper quartile in terms of performance. So I don't think there's necessarily a problem with microclimating is the summary I come to. I will perform some more tests. It's very difficult to find a day where there is actually still and no wind at all. It's very rare, especially in this location, as though there's always some wind channeling down between the houses down that sort of wind tunnel. And this is a defrost cycle, so you can see some steam just starting to come out the front of the unit. So what's happened is the moisture in the air has been cooled, condenser element at the back, which is then frozen. So what happens is the unit then goes into a defrost cycle. It reverses the flow of the hot water, the primary flow water, and that melts the ice, and then it's blown out. And this is how it looks in the open energy monitoring setup. So normal flow is at the top, in the left and right hand side. And where it dips below is where that flow return has swapped over. It runs for about 5 minutes. I think I can do the timing there. You're just over 5 minutes. So it doesn't affect the heat in the house. You don't notice it. And depending on how cold it is and how much moisture is in the air will depend on how frequently that runs. Ours runs probably either once an hour, maybe twice an hour on a really cold, damp day. But yeah, that's there you go. So any questions, give us a shout, drop them in the comments down below, and thank you for watching. Take care.